scope of what is truth and what is knowledge and what's happening to us to really grasp why things are so bizarre, why everybody is suffering. And in order to do that, we got to go down the rabbit hole really fast and really deep. But I know your listeners can handle that.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
So here's the deal. If you wanted to call them the Illuminati or the planetary cabal, they're not running this game. They're being manipulated by extraterrestrials. And those extraterrestrials need fear as a food supply. They call it louche. And so what they're doing is, the closer that this cabal gets to being exposed and defeated, which is happening, and there's more and more signs of that, which we can talk about, there is more and more pushback from the spiritual realms, and these negative entities do have the ability to mess around and do things. So everything is reaching this point of crashing drama because these bad guys do not want to lose. And so they're fighting with everything they've got. They're trying constantly to create new wars and new problems for us.
We have so many examples of that this year, not only in the domestic sense with what is going on with race and Ferguson and our police and that infrastructure. We have
freaking Ebola.
Right. We have Ebola. We have MH17, MH370.
Yeah.
Crimea, Russia, North Korea. All
Israel
of this is
bombing the Palestinians. It's yeah.
Yes. 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 Are these all examples of us not allowing it to get crazier?
There are so many things that could have spiraled out of control that didn't spiral out of control. If you look at, as I'm sure your listeners know, the Georgia Guidestones.
Yes.
It's a Stonehenge-like monument of 14-foot-tall gigantic granite blocks in Georgia. And it has a series of guidelines on it, so to speak, in all these different languages. And the number one guideline is that they want to, whoever did it, wants to keep the population on Earth under 500 million people. And nobody has ever taken these down, and they're protected. And one of the big things that happened this year was that a cube was put up there on the top of the one that's in English. And the cube had a cipher in it that described that these guys who built it, which I do believe is the cabal, intended to achieve their goals in 2014. And the cube, we can discuss how this is deciphered, but the cube gave us two dates. One date was the day that the government shut down in 2013,
yep.
The exact day that it shut down. And the second date was the exact day that the Ferguson riots got they're most violent. And so when you see that that cube was dated 2014, it seems clear that they were hoping to create large-scale riots and a government shutdown. And that was the symbolism of the cube. And yet we're now all the way through 2014. There's only a week left, and those goals did not happen.
Who stopped it?
Ultimately, we're dealing with a spiritual battle, and if you only look at it in terms of who's here on Earth, you're not going to really get what's happening. There are ETs all over the place. There's a whole lot of interest in our planet right now. There's all kinds of new people out there that are not usually the people that hang out in our solar system. There's a whole lot of very, very interesting stuff going on. If you have contact with the type of insiders that I do, which unfortunately very, very few people are in contact with these guys, so I'm one of the only people that can actually leak this kind of information to the public.
With when it comes to the confrontations that were going down, we were right on the brink there with Russia for a minute with Crimea, and certainly we're dealing with ISIS too, which could spiral out of control at any second. We're also dealing with North Korea. But with Russia, that was a pretty scary thing. Went right up to the brink. Who is dealing with Putin and Obama to chill out that situation before it did spiral out of control? Because it was right there.
Well, again, I have to speak in terms of what I really know, and I'm not going to dumb it down for you because that's disrespectful based on what I do know.
Right.
So you got to understand that this is essentially a proxy war that we're seeing on Earth. And what a proxy war means is, like, for example, the Korean War was really U.S. versus USSR, but the USSR had, you know, was supporting the Koreans, and then America was supporting the other side. So Afghanistan was another example. The Afghanistan war was essentially a U.S. versus USSR proxy war. So what we're seeing on Earth is a like between the U.S. and Russia is ultimately a proxy war between factions of extraterrestrial groups that are providing intel and actual strategy and even intervention and battle actions. So it's rather complicated to explain, but there's all kinds of stuff going on behind the scenes right now that if the average person knew about it, it would completely be the taking the red pill approach. You know,
what can we do as a civilization, both positive and negative? What can we do?
Yeah, that is the question. Okay, because a lot of people do talk about this secret space program and the spiritual aspect, and you have to remember that the universe is not built to be staggeringly complex. The answers are simple. And the good guys ultimately are working off of a cosmic free will principle. And that means that what really matters is how we choose to think and act towards others. And that allows the positive guys to be able to do more when we act more positively. So, for example, this is why when you look at the meditation effect, you can have 7,000 people meditating together, and the amount of crime and terrorism worldwide will decrease by 72%. So this group of 7,000 people under one roof somewhere in the world, doesn't matter where they are, if they're in the right state of consciousness, they have this severely disproportionate effect on the amount of hostilities and fatalities in the world. And by the way, this has been scientifically proven in over 39 different documented studies, so that it's indisputable. All other variables were ruled out. Our consciousness is so much more powerful than we realize, and the bad guys are constantly trying to use that against us by such things as predictive programming, where they put out in a movie like the latest Dawn of the Planet of the Apes movie. The whole movie, if you watch that film, the very first scene in the film is a global apocalypse caused by some sort of Ebola type of virus.
Mm-hmm.
That you take it for granted as soon as you watch this movie within the first 2 minutes that almost everybody died of Ebola. And then the whole movie has scenes where you see these FEMA zones where everybody was quarantined before they all died. And now the FEMA zones are all overgrown by trees and vines and stuff. But they show you this throughout the whole movie. They show you houses that have X's on the windows because the people in there were dead. But it's all long gone now. So what they're doing when they put stuff like that out there is they're predictive programming. They want you to load that hologram in your mind and believe that this is what's going to happen so that they can then fire emotional energy into it when they create false flag events. And the false flag events create trauma, which make people think about the things they saw, like in those movies. And then when we start putting our creative power into those thoughts and believe them, that allows the negative to accomplish more of these goals. So it's very important for us to focus on positive outcomes and really emphasize what we can do to create harmony in our own lives and for others. Because as I said, with the meditation effect, that has a very strong effect on people's free will and on how things turn out on Earth. And I do believe that's why we haven't seen any major wars or massive fatalities this year.
I agree with you on that. And I'll tell you something else that's interesting, and I'd like your answer on this. We have so many films that always show the apocalypse, the end, whether it's a zombie or an E.T. movie. Yeah, it's all about that. How come we, or maybe we should, why don't we make a movie that that shows how we're being fed the lifelike hologram of the apocalypse that is being fed? Why isn't there a movie, the one singular movie that comes out that lays it out in that respect?
Amy Berg tried to release a movie that was documenting pedophilia in Hollywood, and she got one premiere showing in New York, and we haven't seen or heard anything more about that movie ever since.
Have you seen?
So you got to be very careful about the term "we" here, because "we" implies that it's a democratic process where anybody can get a film financed and made.
Right.
It doesn't work that way.
That's my point.
Yep.
That's exactly my point. That's exactly my point. Why can't that film get made? It certainly seems, even if you look at something like Pacific Rim or Transformers, it's all the same thing. You know, it's always the end of everything. It's the end. It's the end.
I remember somebody talking about Tom Cruise being interviewed for his movie Edge of Tomorrow, which I actually really liked. But it's such a taken for granted that he's in an interview and he goes, okay, so the premise of the film is aliens are invading the Earth. And it's like he just zooms right through that. Like, oh, yeah, aliens are invading. Boom. Let's go on from there. You know? If you looked at the number of alien invasion films versus positive extraterrestrial films,
I don't know of one. I don't know of a positive one.
Well, there's one recently that came out. It's a low-budget indie flick called Earth to Echo. It's pretty good.
Oh, yeah,
but
yeah,
there's really not very many.
Right. I guess, what was the one with Keanu Reeves, the remake?
Oh, the Day the Earth Stood Still.
Yeah, Day the Earth Stood Still. So I guess that kind of, you know, I guess.
Even that film had some very upsetting and disturbing images in it, you know?
Yeah, and back to the point that we were making earlier, all of the events over the last, all the big seminal events, whether it was the kickoff of World War One, World War Two, and the events that led up to that, the Korean War, Gulf of Tonkin, Cuba, going into Iraq the first, the second time, everything seems to have some kind of crazy false flag type of event tied into it. And it goes all the way into Crimea. And now what we're dealing with North Korea, is each one of these just a situation where we're pawns in chess, you know, and there's a big chessboard out there and the game is being played right in front of us?
That statement would imply that we don't have any power to affect the outcome. And I wouldn't say that we're disempowered. I would say that this is historically how the game has been played. And I would say that the only way we have to stop it is by spreading awareness. And as people like your listeners are getting educated about this, it's becoming common knowledge. A female friend of mine had a mother who's very conservative, very much locked in the traditional matrix mentality. And about a half a year ago, she goes, "Do you think that the Bush administration was behind 9/11? Yeah.
Oh, man, really?
Yeah. I mean, they even asserted that in the Iron Man 3 movie, which was the top movie of 2013. In Iron Man 3, there is a Bin Laden-type villain called the Mandarin, who at the end of the film turns out to be hired by, guess who? The Vice President of the United States of America. And the guy playing the President of the United States is probably the closest-looking actor they could have possibly found to George W.
Yes.
Unbelievable.
Check this out. This question just came in via email, and it's it says, "Jimmy, a while back I saw a YouTube video where David Wilcock was talking about the fall of the Illuminati, literally tons of gold bullion hidden underwater and a plan to arrest heads of state, top bankers, and their cronies. Haven't heard an update on that. Can you please ask him? Please, please, please."
Sure.
So there you go. Please, David, please.
All right. This is a very complicated subject, and I'm happy to give information within a certain range of tolerance. Part of the problem is actually people like me, and I have to apologize to humanity right up front in saying that in some cases, internet journalists such as myself, in our zeal to try to get too specific, information unbeknownst to me was too precise and got people killed in commanding positions that were trying to get this mass arrest to happen. So sometimes in the past, we have naively given away too much, and entire command structures that were trying to pull this off have gotten fragged and killed. So this is a very, very serious war. It's very real. But there are some things I can say that are not going to get anybody killed. And one of them is okay, number one, this is going to happen. And once it does, people are going to be listening to this show by the millions and other shows like this where I talk about it. So I want to make one point extremely clear. I am not involved in this. Nobody is asking me what to do. I have no commanding role. I have no decision-making authority whatsoever. All I'm doing is getting leaks from other people who are making the decisions themselves. I do not have control over what they're going to do, how they're going to do it, when they're going to do it, where they're going to do it, nothing. Okay?
Okay.
What I do know, I can tell you this. There are multiple groups all over the world who have had to sort out their differences and come to a common consensus about what they're going to do and how they're going to do it. That consensus has been reached. It's been reached for about 2 months.
Mm.
However, prior to that point, there was a great deal of disagreement about how they were actually going to pull this off, because you're ultimately dealing with uprooting a structure that can use murderous force and very powerful international media propaganda to promote its agenda. So it's extremely lethal to try to go up against this cabal and very, very dangerous. So during the time that this international alliance, which includes a major faction from the East, a major faction from Russia, a major faction from Europe, lesser factions from South America, lesser factions from the Middle East, from Arab countries, all different groups, including splinter factions in terms of groups that were in alignment with Bush that broke away, groups that were in alignment with the Rothschilds and broke away, groups that were in alignment with the Vatican and broke away. There are all these players involved. They all have different wants and needs, and they all had to come to a consensus. Now, some of the groups wanted there to be complete amnesty and wanted there to not be any fatalities as this process takes place. That decision has been vetoed. There are going to be spontaneous assassinations that take place. So there is going to be some violence when this starts to happen. It's going to freak people out. It's going to be very controversial. I may have to garrison myself in my house for a while once this happens. But I'm telling you, part of the reason why we're leaking this before it happens is so that when it starts to happen, the propaganda matrix is not going to be able to make this look like a coup. And it's not going to be able to make it look like it's some sort of Russian intel operation where they're trying to destroy America. That's not what this is going to be. It's going to be a very positive change, because if you're worried about a coup over the United States government, guess what? It already happened, and it was called Hanging Chads in the 2000 presidential election.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a millennial and you were too young and you're fiddling around with the computer and not paying attention, go back and look at what happened in 2000.
Mm-hmm.
That's when the coup happened. That's what we've got to reverse now.
When you talk about assassinations, are you talking about heads of state or bankers?
Yeah, I don't think Obama's going to get shot. He'll probably be brought into a tribunal, and he's going to end up crying and, you know, testifying of all the stuff that happened and the stuff that they made him do.
Hmm.
And there's probably going to be – most of the heads of state will probably be fine. If you watch the movie Captain America, Winter Soldier, that film is a documentary. They're telling you exactly what they're going to do. And what happens at the end is there is a the basic premise of the film is that the group SHIELD that we saw in the Avengers is actually essentially the NSA and other groups like that, CIA, et cetera. I can tell you that there has been a coup within the CIA. The CIA is now 60% in control of the alliance. What that means is that the CIA is now working for the good of humanity and Americans, and for patriotic Americans. So they're not, the CIA has had a total overhaul. One of the groups that is still in control of the cabal is Homeland Security. So there is a major battle going on between CIA and Homeland Security, among other groups. This is exemplified in the Winter Soldier film. And one of the things that you see in there is that a Nazi group called Hydra took over the American intelligence apparatus after the Nazis were brought here after World War II in something called Project Paperclip. They talk about this in the movie. And this was the second biggest movie of this year, other than I think Hunger Games then exceeded it. But the movie is telling you what they're going to do, and the leader of Hydra is shot to death at the end of the movie. So they're telling you that there are going to be probably a certain number of targeted assassinations. Now, again, nobody's asking me how to handle this, but it would also be extremely presumptuous for me to assume that I could understand what the tactical significance of those assassinations are or why that would be necessary. I'm not in any type of role to really understand what they're facing or what's going on. I personally would not vote for anybody to be assassinated. The more bloodless they can do this, if they could do it in a peaceful way, that would be ideal. And maybe there will still be some sort of divine intervention where events will take place in a certain way where it doesn't have to be bloody. I certainly hope that's what's going to happen. But we could actually see 2 or 3 weeks here in America where you're going to have exactly the same type of crazy headlines that were going on during the Boston bombing. Mm-hmm. And if you remember watching the internet on the Boston bombing, I mean, I was on the edge of my seat. And every big news website, it was all big, bold, red letters, you know. So there's going to be a lot of that for a while.
Is it...